Hey, what's up guys? I'm Theo Joe, and today I've got a bunch of cool stuff for you. 15 tips that really everyone should know about using your computer. Some of these are Windows specific, some are just for any computer, some have to do with browsers, so we got a lot of variety. You should find it pretty interesting, so why don't we get started? First up, now hopefully everyone already knows how to click and drag a file. You left click, drag it into another folder, and it moves it there. But did you know you can actually right click and drag files in Windows? That's right, I bet you never even tried it before. What you do is you just click and hold with a right click, just as you would with a left click, and move it into another folder. And instead of moving it right away, it will actually bring up a context menu with a few options, whether you want to copy, move, or create a shortcut. So this could be a lot easier than having to right click every file, doing copy and paste, or even using keyboard shortcuts. This could be faster than all of that. And if you have other programs that do copy and paste, those should show up in the context menu as well. So pretty cool, you might not have known about that. Next up, number two, has to do with selecting text. Now obviously if you click and drag regularly, it selects text by the character. But if you didn't already know, you can actually double click, and on the second click you start dragging, and it will select text by the word instead of just by the character. And you can actually triple click, and it will select by the entire paragraph. So if you know that you're going to be selecting an entire paragraph of stuff, triple clicking will make it a lot easier to select individual paragraphs without having to get it exact with the character level. Also, on top of that, if you hold down Alt and start to select text, it will allow you to select vertical sections of text instead of having to do it just line by line. So that could be useful too, although I don't think that works in Chrome, unfortunately. Should work everywhere else. All right, now the next few are specific to Google Chrome, but they might work in other browsers as well. So number three is that if you want to search within a specific site, you can actually go into the address bar, type that name of the website, like google.com or maybe facebook.com, and instead of pressing enter, if you press tab, it will allow you to enter a query that will only search within that site. There are advanced ways to type in commands into the Google search bar to do this, but this is way easier. You can do it right in Chrome, and it's just as simple as typing in an address bar. Just type in the website, tab, and search, and you're good to go. Number four is one that you are going to love if you didn't know this one already. So in Google Chrome, if you accidentally close out a browser tab, you can bring it back with the most powerful command, Control-Shift-T. And it will restore the tab that you just closed accidentally, or even closed several tabs ago. It will restore them one by one, even if you close three in a row. Also, even if you close out Chrome altogether, if you close the program, then open it up again and press Control Shift T, it will bring up the tab that you just closed last. So this is a great way to restore tabs if you, I don't know, your computer crashes, or you accidentally close the whole program or just a tab. Really useful. Although one important note is this will not work in incognito mode for pretty obvious reasons. The whole idea is with incognito mode, it doesn't save history at all. So once you close a tab, it's gone for good. Number five, this one is a really quick one for YouTube. So obviously you guys can all enjoy it. If you ever want to watch a video looped, like a song or something like that, all you have to do is right click on the video and hit loop. And if it doesn't show up in the dropdown, for example, if you're not using HTML5 or something like that, if you right click twice without moving the cursor, it will bring up the normal context menu you're used to instead of the custom YouTube one. And there will also be another option to loop it that way. Number six, this one can be pretty fun. It will allow you to edit any web page to say whatever you want, so you can mess with friends or create fake screenshots or whatever you want. And all you have to do is right click in Chrome and hit inspect, or you can press F12 to bring up the same menu, and then go to the console in Chrome and type in the following command. document.designmode equals on with on in quotes. And like I just said, this will put the page into designer mode, which means you can highlight and type in new text and change it just like you would a Word document or something like that. And there's also very similar to functionality in Firefox. All you have to do is right click and hit inspect again, just like in Chrome. And in this way, it's a little bit different. I don't know if there's an actual design mode, but you can still go into the page source and change text and it will show up on the page. So it's basically the same thing, just a little bit more difficult possibly. Moving on, number seven, another Windows one. Now, if you already know how to do Alt Tab, that's pretty useful. It allows you to switch between different windows quickly. If you play a lot of video games that are full screen, this is especially useful. But did you know that there's a better looking version of Alt Tab that is the Windows Key Tab? So this is gonna look a little bit different depending on which version of Windows you have. But for example, in Windows 10, if you press Windows Tab, it kind of brings up like a view and it could give you a better idea of what's actually in those windows as opposed to just Alt Tab, which shows you a little tiny thumbnail. It might look better depending on which system you're on. Number 8, this one's gonna be for people who are a little bit more advanced. You know that if you ever have to run a command with a command prompt in a specific folder, you usually have to use the CD change directory command and type in the whole location, or you have to right click in the folder, do open command prompt here. It's pretty complicated, but there is a much easier way. In Windows Explorer, all you have to do is go to the address bar for that window and type in CMD, and it will automatically open command prompt to that folder path without you having to do anything extra. It's very simple, very quick. Number 9, this one is a very general tip for really any type of computer, but if you're ever having problems with your computer, it's not working, and you have to go to your IT department for help, and you want to describe the problem, you have to do it very specifically and say what you did, you know, what was the context of the problem, what it's showing, instead of just saying it's not working. I don't know how many times I've had friends who are saying, oh, this program isn't working. And I'll say, well, what's wrong with it? And they'll just say, it's an error message. It's like, that does not help at all. I can't help you with that. So don't expect your IT department to just have a magic wand where they run one command and it fixes everything. They usually have to figure out specifically what went wrong. So you have to be specific in what you see and what you are expecting, and it'll just be faster for everyone. All right, number 10. This one is really important when you go to install a program, and that is to not always just click right through the installer and accept everything right away. You want to actually read which options you're selecting, because a lot of times these programs, especially free installers, will have extra bloatware that they install along with the program. If you just click through without checking the option to not do that, you're gonna get a lot of extra crap on your PC. Because if you didn't know, a lot of freeware, free programs are supported by other software that will pay to have that free program install their toolbar or whatever along with it. So it's kind of like advertising, because they assume that a lot of people are just gonna click next, next, next without checking what they're installing. So they want their program on as many computers as they want, no matter what. So a lot of times these options will be under something like custom installation or advanced installation. And it'll say automatic installation recommended. Yeah, because it's gonna install all the junk. So anytime you can, always click custom installation or advanced installation and see what the options are. And if it says accept or deny, look at what you're actually accepting, because it might say deny installing this junk that you don't need to install along with it. So just be aware of all that. Number 11, this one is gonna save a lot of you guys headaches, and it is the Gmail undo send option. So if you didn't know, yes, Gmail has an option to undo sending within a certain time frame. And to enable it, all you do is go to the gear option in Gmail, go to settings, and then go to the general settings, scroll down, and you'll see an option to enable undo send, and you have to enable it, and then you would have an option to delay it by 5 to 30 seconds. And within that time frame, after you send an email, you have the option to just click undo and it won't send it. So it's not like it takes the email back, but rather it delays sending it by that number of seconds. So if you realize right after clicking it, oh my gosh, I sent it to the wrong person, or I replied all, or something crazy like that, you can just undo it and fix it before it goes out to everybody. Number 12, this is another Gmail one, and this is that you can actually create multiple email addresses, kind of, with your one Gmail account. And what I mean by that is, say you have your email address, if I use theojoketest@gmail.com, you can actually add a plus and then anything after that first part of the email address, and it will still work. And this is really useful, for example, if you get a lot of spam. Let's say you're signing up for Facebook. What you can do is type in your username plus Facebook@gmail.com, and then it will still go to your email address, but now Facebook thinks that's your email address. So if they were to sell your email address to spammers, then it's gonna be still going to that custom email. So that can be really useful, but you should keep in mind that sometimes websites will be aware of this and they might not let you do this. It might say enter a valid email, but most of the time it should still work. Number 13, this is gonna fix one of the most annoying things in Windows, which is if you have an update pending to install, if you go to shut down your computer or restart it, it will make you install the updates before you do so. And sometimes you don't want to do that. You want to restart the computer quickly and you don't have to wait for all the updates. Well, there is a way to bypass installing the updates and to just shut it down or restart right away. So what you do is you go to the desktop and make sure the desktop is in focus by just clicking somewhere on the desktop and then pressing Alt F4. And that's the reason you want the desktop open, because Alt F4 normally closes programs, but if you're on the desktop, it actually opens up a context menu with some options to shut down, which in addition to the options of shutting down and restarting and installing updates, you can just shut down or restart directly. Now, I don't actually see this option because I don't have any pending updates, but it would be there. Another way to do this is if you press Control-Alt-Delete and it brings up the blue screen with the different options, if you click on the bottom right power button icon, it will also allow you to shut down or restart directly with the same options. All right, coming near the end, number 14, this is gonna work on any type of computer and operating system, Windows, Mac, whatever. And hopefully you already know this one, but if you didn't, you can actually press Tab when you're entering different text fields and it will automatically move to the next text box. So say you're filling out a sign up form or your address details or something, instead of having to go and click into the next box, you just press Tab. And maybe some of you who knew that one didn't know this, if you press Shift Tab, it will automatically go to the previous box. So if you press Tab too early or accidentally, you can press Shift Tab, it goes back, and you can do it that way as well. Okay, number 15. This one is probably the most important one. It's gonna work on any computer and nobody seems to know it. You're gonna thank me for this one. So not a lot of people realize that every single computer sold has a special feature called an off button. You see, contrary to popular belief, it's actually possible to not be on the computer, and you'll be able to have access to a lot more features, such as one called going outside, which not a lot of people do these days because they don't even know about that feature. And the most useful situation for this is if you're online and maybe you see something you don't like. Normally, everyone would be forced to type out a comment expressing their anger about it. However, now that you know about the new off button, you can actually just turn off your computer completely and limit your exposure to those things you don't like instead of getting angry about them. And then you can go to the outside area. But anyway, jokes aside, hopefully you guys did still find these tips really useful. Maybe even the last one. I think there's a lot of people who really don't genuinely know about going outside. It seems like it. But anyway, if you guys know any other tips, you can let us know down in the comment section. Also, if you want to keep watching, I've got some other videos right here you can watch. I think you'll enjoy those. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. Should be worth it. So I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys again. And as usual, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.